The Pueblo Chemical Agent Destruction Pilot Plant, or PCAPP, is a state-of-the-art facility safely destroying more than 2,613 tons of chemical agent stored at the U.S. Army Pueblo Chemical Depot in Colorado. The Pueblo plant comprises several facilities and support structures on 85 acres of depot land. This includes the main plant and the static detonation chamber complex. The stockpile at the depot originally consisted of 155mm projectiles, 105mm projectiles, and 4.2-inch mortar rounds, all containing mustard agent. These chemical weapons are currently stored on pallets in earthen-covered bunkers known as igloos. Safe, secure storage and monitoring of the chemical weapons stockpile is the mission of the Pueblo Chemical Depot.
I'm proud to be here and I'm proud to be part of this operation.
I feel good that that you're out here and that you're doing what you're supposed to be doing and that you're getting rid of these munitions.
It definitely makes me feel like we're playing a huge role, a very important part to making sure that everything is a lot safer around here, not only for the community, but internationally as well.
PCAPP main plant operations began on September 7th, 2016, and are on track to complete by September 30th, 2023. This video will show the steps required to destroy the remaining stockpile in Pueblo, using neutralization followed by biotreatment as the primary destruction technology. Before destruction of these munitions can begin, they are transported from storage igloos at the depot to the plant's munition service magazines. Transport occurs during daylight under favorable weather conditions. The munitions service magazines provide buffer storage and support continuous plant operations year-round, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. When projectiles are moved from storage igloos, they are monitored to ensure worker and environmental safety. Upon entering the igloos, munition transporters pack the munitions pallet and secure the lid. Up to 3 pallets are loaded into a modified ammunition van, or MAV, for transport to the plant. This van is designed to minimize risk to the environment, the public, and all personnel. The munitions are transported to one of 3 munitions service magazine loading docks, where the pallets are offloaded. Munitions service magazines are made from reinforced concrete to provide safety. In addition, each MAV is monitored to ensure no leakage of chemical agent occurred during transportation. Munitions are then transported to the receiving and traveling area of the Enhanced Reconfiguration Building, or ERB. They are unloaded and monitored. Upon confirmation of no leakage, the cover of the pallet is removed and the munitions are unpacked. Boxed munitions were reconfigured in one of 2 vapor containment rooms. First, the fiber tubes were removed from wooden shipping crates during reconfiguration. Next, the ends of the fiber tubes were removed to access the munitions inside. After these munitions were examined and monitored for possible leaks, they were considered ready for processing. All 3 munition types have been reconfigured at PCAPP since June 2020.
My role personally, it's very small, but I like to think all of us doing our small part in some way contributes to the greater good.
I think it's probably the best part of the job, really, making the world a safer place, getting rid of some really bad stuff.
Palletized munitions that have already had their fuses and assorted parts removed are placed directly onto a conveyor and transported into an explosive containment room, or ECR. An automated system known as the Projectile Mortar Disassembly System, or PMD, is used to remove the weapon's explosive components within the room. The PMD is comprised of 3 identical robots and performs precise munitions placement and parts removal. All 3 PMD stations remove the munitions' energetic components, and a 4th station verifies the removal of the energetics. The ECRs have 24-inch thick concrete walls for added protection. Once the energetics are removed, they are decontaminated and transferred to a static detonation chamber located at the Anniston Army Depot in Alabama for destruction. the munition bodies are transported down a 450-foot corridor to the Agent Processing Building, or APB, by an automated guided vehicle, or AGV. The AGV is an unmanned, remote-controlled vehicle that travels between the two processing buildings, minimizing human involvement while safely transporting the munitions. Upon arrival in the APB, munitions are sent to a station called the Munitions Washout System, or MWS. Within the washout system, a robotic arm places the projectiles in a device known as the Cavity Access Machine, or CAM. This machine is used to access the burster well of the munition to allow for the removal of agent. The munition bodies are thermally treated to ensure no agent residue remains. When mustard agent is mixed with water, the reactiveness of the mustard molecule is neutralized and it breaks down into hydrochloric acid and thiodiglycol. Sodium hydroxide is added to the hydrochloric acid and thiodiglycol mixture. When the hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide combine, an acid-base neutralization occurs, leaving salt and water. The thiodiglycol does not react with the sodium hydroxide, remaining chemically intact. The thiodiglycol, water, and salt are collectively referred to as hydrolysate. This wastewater is pumped into a holding tank where it is sampled and analyzed to verify complete chemical agent destruction. Once determined to be free of agent, holding tank contents are pumped into the biotreatment area, or BTA. After the munition bodies have been drained and rinsed, they are placed into the munitions treatment unit. There, they are heated to 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit for at least 15 minutes, ensuring destruction of any residual chemical agent contamination. The steel munition bodies are collected and later shipped to a permitted recycling center. Every step of the neutralization and biotreatment process is supervised by control room operators. During neutralization, control room teams monitor each munition's journey through destruction. They remotely operate robotics and machinery used during the automated destruction process, as well as look for any issues a munition may experience along the way. The process is designed to limit human interaction with munitions. If hands-on interaction with destruction machinery is required in agent-contaminated areas, a toxic area entry is necessary. During a toxic area entry, workers don a demilitarization protective ensemble, or DPE. The entry process requires extensive and meticulous procedures to safely enter areas to conduct repairs or address issues.
These are the most effective suits I've seen. We've done thousands of entries in demil history, not one agent exposure.
Air monitoring is also a crucial element of the chemical weapons destruction process. PCAPP laboratory technicians perform critical monitoring tasks during the neutralization process to ensure protection of the workforce and the environment. About 200 employees support laboratory operations to ensure 24/7 monitoring.
So every day we have mini cams monitoring different areas throughout the plant to ensure that agent stays in the areas it's supposed to stay in, and the areas that are supposed to stay clean are staying clean. I have a crew of technicians that work with me. We'll go out and challenge and calibrate these on a daily basis.
Biotreatment is necessary to further process mustard hydrolysate, since under the Chemical Weapons Convention, thiodiglycol is classified as a Schedule II precursor chemical and must be destroyed. The biotreatment area consists of three components: three 30-day hydrolysate storage tanks, the immobilized cell bioreactor, or ICB, and the brine reduction system, or BRS. Hydrolysate is stored in the 30-day storage tanks until it is ready to be processed in the ICB.
So when the hydrolysate batches come out to the BTA, they have high levels of TDG, thiodiglycol. So the process out there is supposed to get rid of, or at least below a certain level of TDG in the process. And the main part of that is the immobilized cell bioreactors.
The immobilized cell bioreactor is a feed tank that contains millions of microbes. Using a process like those implemented at wastewater treatment plants, the microbes ingest and biodegrade the thiodiglycol found in hydrolysate. As a result, the thioglycol is removed, leaving water, salt compounds, and microbe waste, collectively known as biotreated effluent. In the brine reduction system, water from the effluent is evaporated and recovered through condensation. It is filtered and recycled into the plant to support the neutralization and biotreatment process. After evaporation, the concentrated brine is pumped into a crystallizer to further reduce volume. All remaining liquid is evaporated within the crystallizer and the salt concentrations form into crystals. The liquid extracted during this step is also condensed, recovered, and filtered. The salt crystals and microbe waste that remain after the second round of evaporation are compressed, resulting in salt cakes. This secondary waste is then shipped to an off-site permitted treatment, storage, and disposal facility. Similar to control room workers overseeing the neutralization process, the entire biotreatment process is overseen by a control room.
So we're basically the ending of the process there. So it comes from inside the plant. It's already been sampled and treated, and it's shipped to our BO4 tanks. Our role is to further treat it in our ICB bioreactors, and then further treat it to B12. We're conserving water.
Using neutralization followed by biotreatment, the plant has successfully finished the destruction campaign for two munition types. On September 5th, 2020, a historic milestone was reached as the final 155mm projectile was eliminated, meaning nearly 300,000 of these munitions were destroyed. On July 20th, 2022, the team completed the 105mm projectile campaign, destroying more than 380,000 munitions. In addition, a portion of the 4.2-inch mortar rounds will be destroyed at the main plant as well. Three static detonation chambers are augmenting the main plant by destroying munitions that cannot be easily processed using automated equipment. Destruction of 4.2-inch mortar rounds began in February 2022. The SDC complex houses three units, each containing a detonation chamber vessel and an off-gas treatment system, or OTS. Munitions are placed in a carrier and conveyed into the electrically heated detonation chamber. Munitions destroyed in an SDC unit are detonated or deflagrated inside a containment vessel that reaches more than 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit or more than 800 degrees Celsius. Thermal decomposition destroys the mustard agent. The off-gas treatment system, which handles SDC emissions, has a thermal oxidizer that converts carbon monoxide and hydrogen to carbon dioxide, water, and acid gases. Gases from the thermal oxidizer are cooled and filtered to remove any contaminants. The SDC produces minimal liquid waste. Scrap metals removed from the vessel may be recycled. Salts from the OTS are treated and disposed of following state and federal laws.
The federal regulations that are then implemented through the state of Colorado are very rigorous to begin with, and we're following all of those to the letter of the law.
The entire off-gas treatment system is state-of-the-art. The regulatory requirements are extremely high.
The Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons, or OPCW, monitors the destruction process as part of its role as the implementing body of the Chemical Weapons Convention Treaty, which bans the development, production, storage, and use of chemical weapons worldwide. The OPCW inspection team witnesses the collection of the chemical agent sample via closed-circuit television in the Treaty Office facility and physically witnesses the sample analysis in the laboratory. The Pueblo Chemical Agent Destruction Pilot Plant is honoring its commitment to the local community, nation, and world to destroy the U.S. chemical weapons stockpile in Colorado. Protection of the environment surrounding PCAPP is one of the project's top priorities. Plant personnel follow all issued environmental permits and must continually monitor destruction activities to ensure operations are safe for the workforce, community, and environment. Thanks to the skill and dedication of the workforce, the stockpile destruction mission is on target to be completed safely and compliantly in accordance with the Chemical Weapons Convention Treaty commitment date of September 30th, 2023.
We are very, very interested, vested into making our commitments and seeing them through. I can proudly tell my neighbors what I do here.
We're doing something not only for the country, but also for the world.
Someday somebody's gonna read about what you did here at Pueblo. I believe in making history.